Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. So far, we have studied linear equations which describe lines in the Cartesian plane. In the next few lectures, we will explore several types of geometric relationships that can exist between two linear equations. One possibility is that the lines described by two linear equations can be parallel. As we have seen, any non-vertical line in the Cartesian plane can be uniquely identified by specifying its slope and a point which lies on the line. If the point falls on the y-axis, the equation of the line can be written in slope-intercept form. In this form, the constant m is the slope of the line, and the constant b is the y-coordinate of the y-intercept. If we write a second equation in slope-intercept form, which uses the same value for m, but a different y-intercept, both lines described by these equations will have the same slope, but no points in common. We say that these two lines are parallel to each other. Parallel lines have identical slopes, but no points in common. As a result, parallel lines on a flat plane never intersect. Let's say that we are given the equation for a line, and are asked to write a second equation for a parallel line which runs through a given point which does not lie on the y-axis. Since the two lines are parallel, we know that the slope of the second line must be the same as the slope of the first line. However, we cannot write the equation using slope-intercept form since we don't know the second line's y-intercept. However, we can use point-slope form, since we know the line's slope and the coordinates x1 and y1 of the given point which lies on the line. It is easy to tell if two equations written in slope-intercept form describe parallel lines. If the slope m is the same in both equations, and b is different, then the equations describe two lines with the same slope, but which intercept the y-axis at different points. In other words, two parallel lines. On the other hand, two equations written in point-slope form, which have the same value for the slope m, may describe parallel lines, or they may both describe the same line, even when the two equations contain different values for x1 and y1. This is because the point represented by x1 and y1 in the first equation and the point represented by x1 and y1 in the second equation may fall on the same line. In that case, even though both equations look different, they actually describe the same line. Since in point-slope form, any one of an infinite number of points on the line may be used to determine the values of x1 and y1, there are an infinite number of different equations which can be written that describe the same line. So, when two equations written in point-slope form have the same value for m, but different values for x1 and y1, how can we determine if they describe parallel lines or the same line? One easy way to test whether two equations with the same slope describe different lines is to find where each line crosses the y-axis. If the two equations intersect the y-axis at different points, then they do not describe the same line. On the other hand, if two equations with the same slope intersect the y-axis at the same point, then both equations must describe the same line. The y-intercept for each equation can be found by setting x to 0. The resulting value of y in each equation is the y-coordinate of each line's y-intercept. To solve the equations for y, we first eliminate the zeros and complete the arithmetic, multiplying 1/2 times negative 2 to get negative 1 and 1/2 times negative 6 to get negative 3. We then add 6 to both sides of the first equation and 8 to both sides of the second equation, allowing us to cancel the negative and positive 6s and the negative and positive 8s. Completing the arithmetic, negative 1 plus 6 is 5, and negative 3 plus 8 is also 5. So for both equations, when x is 0, y is 5. Therefore, both equations have the same y-intercept. Since the equations have the same slope and y-intercept, they both describe the same line. Now let's try this one more time, but with different values for x1 and y1 in the second equation. Once again, we find the y-intercepts for each equation by setting x to 0 and solving for y. We first eliminate the zeros and complete the arithmetic, multiplying 1/2 times negative 2 to get negative 1, and 1/2 times negative 10 to get negative 5. To rearrange the equation so that y is alone on the left side, we add 6 to both sides of the first equation, and 7 to both sides of the second equation, allowing us to cancel the negative and positive 6s, and the negative and positive 7s. Completing the arithmetic, negative 1 plus 6 is 5, and negative 5 plus 7 is 2. So when x is 0, the value of y is different in each equation. Each equation has a different y-intercept. Since both equations have the same slope but different y-intercepts, they describe parallel lines. In this lecture, we have seen how linear equations can describe parallel lines. In the next lecture, we will see how linear equations can be created which describe perpendicular lines.